Saturday the 27th of May, and it seems that we are promised good weather for the bank holiday weekend. That's quite a novelty. Our opening prayer for today. In the morning, Lord, you hear our voices, and in the morning we lay our requests before you. For each and every day, we wait expectantly for your response. May this day be full of your presence. Amen. Today's readings are Psalm 121 and Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 20. I recently saw a program about training firefighters. It really is mind-blowing how much equipment they need to put on in order to stay safe whilst tackling a fire. I'm really not sure how they manage to move around at all, let alone go up ladders. But theirs is a very dangerous job, and they need to be fully protected against all eventualities. It may sometimes seem that a fire has been put out, but then another one starts in a previously fire-free area, or suddenly part of the building collapses near to them. Firefighting really is a challenging battle. And when it comes to the spiritual battle, we often have no idea whatsoever where the fires of the devil will crop up. That's why St. Paul clearly says that we must stand firm against the devil's schemes, which include the dark powers of this world and the spiritual forces of evil. Knowing that these spiritual battles will crop up inevitably, God makes sure that we are fully equipped. He doesn't leave us without protection for every area, although we do of course have to make sure that we use our protection. We need to be confident in the victory of Jesus Christ. The dark powers can be a considerable inconvenience to us, but they can't be. And that's why we can be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. But most of all, we are encouraged to be faithful in prayer, the ultimate protection for us. We now come to our next prayer. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ is the true vine, help us to make space for you in our lives, to abide in you as you abide in us. Give us grace to grow as Christians in our community, to follow Jesus' example and listen to your call, that through our words and our actions, we might bear fruit and show the hope and joy of Jesus Christ in the world. For today's prayer points, we really must start by praying for the safety of everyone who works in our emergency services. Pray for people who are displaced from their homes because of disasters. And pray that God's protection is with us all. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Tomorrow is Pentecost Sunday. That's why I'm wearing my bright orange jacket today. Just a reminder of the orange flames, which are quite often used to depict Pentecost Sunday. And our services tomorrow are at 9:30 and the 11 o'clock here at St. Aidan's. The St. Luke's are continuing to meet in St. Wilfrid's Academy at 11 o'clock. Oh, bless me. God, fill your hearts with his love and give you courage to proclaim his kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.